Hello, friends, and welcome to another video. Today, I'm going to be ordering a customized mascara online. So this company, Eyeko, offers a bespoke mascara service where you go online and answer a short quiz, and from your answers, they'll make you a personalized mascara formula with a tailored brush. They also offer this service in person in London, Paris, and Hong Kong, but since I don't live in any of those places, I'm gonna have to do it on the good old interwebs. I like the idea of customized or personalized mascara, and I do have a few eyelash concerns. Number one, being that I have a couple unruly lashes that sort of grow in a different direction than they're supposed to. And number two being that when coated, my lashes can tend to get clumpy or spidery. Also, I don't know if they can help with this, but I oftentimes hit myself in the face with my mascara wand as I'm applying it to my lashes, and I'd like to stop doing that. So I'm interested to see if this customized mascara is any better than what I'm used to, but I also wonder how much they can really do to customize your mascara. So I'm gonna order one custom formula based on my eyelash concerns, and then, as an investigation, I'm gonna order a second tube with completely different answers, so I can have two tubes to compare and contrast. All right! Let's get started. I've used the brand Eyeko a couple of times before, but I think they're like a primarily European-based brand, so I haven't come into contact with them a lot. The first thing on their website is yoga waterproof mascara, which I guess is mascara for when you are doing yoga. Ah, here we go. So they've got this video that says, what makes the perfect mascara? You do. Ah. Wait, is there volume? Oh, it's a quiet video. This is basically just like a silent animated video telling you how to take this quiz.
It's like the artist for quiz tests.
Ooh, and then we've got some reviews down here. Fun fact, if you have a mascara emergency in central London, you can get it delivered in 90 minutes. All right, Eyeko, coming for Postmates wig. All right, I think we should just take this quiz. I'm gonna click shop now. Okay, so here's the first question. How would you describe your natural lashes? All right, number one, unruly. I said that was one of my lash concerns before. I think my lashes are naturally long and medium. I wouldn't call them fine, but I also wouldn't call them full. So I guess that's three options. All right, question number two. Which effect is most important to you when choosing mascara? I definitely am gonna want length and definition. I don't necessarily need it to be waterproof, but long wearing would be nice. Added curl could maybe help for the unruliness, perhaps. All right, next. Oh, I just realized there was no option for stop hitting myself in the face. All right, so question number three is, now we've got to know you, now that we've got to know you, we'd recommend one of these brushes. The first one seems to be like ultra curling. The second one seems to be like ultra volumizing. And the third one seems to be more like on the go, like do it real quick. I kind of want to see what they think based off of this quiz I would need. So I'm going to tell them to choose for me and see how that works out. All right, so this little cat says that he's making my formula. And here we go. It says, introducing your bespoke mascara. It's $40 and it says I can monogram it for $4. Sure, I like my initials. SN, that's me. And if I scroll down a little bit more, it tells me a little bit about like what I've just ordered. With natural conditioners, including shea butter, our classic tubing formula promises ultra black smooth application every time. And then for the brush, they've chosen quick fix, volume, curl, and separation in one sweep. Okay, cool. So that is customized mascara number one. So I'm gonna add this to the bag, and then I'm gonna do the quiz again, just to see how different the formulas are and how much like your answers really matter. For this one, I'm gonna say that my lashes are curly, fine, and short. I don't think I would say any of those things about my current lashes. So for the second question, I think I'm gonna choose that I want a volumizing effect, a body boosting effect, and I also want it to be waterproof. All right, next. So looking at the brushes, two of them I haven't seen before. The first brush though is the quick fix brush, which is what they gave me with my last formula. All right, well I'm gonna ask them to choose for me again just to see what they have to say. All right, here we go. So it does look like for the your formula blurb that they've written something different, but my my last formula was also a tubing formula, so I'm not sure if that's like one of their favorite things for like a lot of different lash types, or if it's actually a very similar formula. And for my brush, they've chosen for me the Twist and Shout. Short spirals will extend and lengthen each and every lash. So they did give me a different brush, which is cool. All right, Tyler, do you want me to monogram this for you?
Yeah.
All right, so the second one is the Tyler Williams. So I've got two customized mascaras in my bag, and they're also giving me a free waterproof shadow liner. Let's check out. So I think I've placed my order now. They gave me free 48-hour FedEx delivery, which is fun because I usually have to wait months for things to come in the mail to me. But anyways, next time you see me, I'll have one customized mascara and one customized mascara. All right, so both of my custom mascaras have arrived. It did take a little bit more than 48 hours. I'd say it took probably like 3 to 5 days, but I believe I have both of them in here. So let's open them up and take a look and see how they are and also how different they are from each other. Ta-da!
A piece of paper.
And a little cat. He says, lash alert. Alert your lashes. The British are coming. Oh, wow. This is fancy. Should I try and break the seal or no? Just kidding, I can't break it. I'm going around it. Ooh! I have what looks like two very fancy pens. All right, so this is the Me and My Shadow Waterproof Shadow Liner, which is, oh my God! Well, just gonna stick that back in there and pretend that didn't happen. So basically I've got like a little bit of like a stick shadow on one side. And on this side, I have a little brush. I'm a little confused by this product. All right, I'm gonna put that away. And these are our custom mascaras. This one is mine. You see the SN on the side. And Tyler, that's yours.
Thank you.
Wait, give it back. All right, so I'm gonna start off with my customized mascara and apply it to my right eye. Whoa! Oh, there's a mirror in there.
Hello.
Hello. What are you doing in there? And then I'm gonna guess that this is our mascara. And I think this little card says the ingredients. All right, let's unwrap this guy. Ooh. On one side, it's got the E with the crown. And on the other side, it says the original tube mascara. Hold up, hold up. I paid $4 extra for my mascara to be monogrammed. But I think the only thing they did is add these stickers. I thought that they were just like letting me know which was which, and I thought that the bottle would have some sort of etching into it, but it does not. I think I paid $4 for these two stickers. That makes me a little bit upset. All right. Shall I open it?
Yes.
I don't care what you say, I'm opening it anyway.
Okay.
Ooh. All right, so this formula is supposed to add length and definition, curl, and it's also supposed to last like all day. The quick fix brush is basically just supposed to do it fast. It's like in one sweep, do all of the effects. And I'm seeing a lot. All right, so I'm gonna do the bottom lashes now. Oh no, I hit myself in the face. All right, so that is my customized mascara on this eye. I would say that a lot of the supposed value propositions are coming through. I think that the lashes look a lot longer than they did before. And I do think that it is much curlier as well. I'm not sure about the definition. It's not clumpy, but it's like a little spidery. So on to the next mascara, the TW mascara. See, you know what the problem is here? Now that we have two of these things, and the tubes are not monogrammed, how are we gonna know which one's which?
Well, if they're really customized, maybe you'll be able to tell the difference.
But only after you put it on.
I didn't say it was a perfect solution.
All right, so this brush is the Twist and Shout brush. It's supposed to give me some volume, length, curl, all that jazz. Ready?
Yeah.
All right. So this formula is supposed to be body boosting, volumizing, and also waterproof. All right, I'm gonna do the bottom. I have got mascara all over me. All right, so I think that that is pretty much that application of that TW mascara. My first impression of it is that the effect is somewhat similar, but I do like the brush of the other mascara a lot more. I think that when you're really up close with the camera, like you can tell like, oh, this one is curlier and longer. But any further away than that, they look pretty similar. Okay, so those are both of the customized mascaras. I'm gonna wear them for the rest of the day and see if like a long wear test illuminates anything more. Okay, so it's been about 5.5 to 6 hours since I first applied this mascara, and I have to say they're both going pretty strong. This right eye is supposed to be long-lasting. I picked the all-day, air-a-day option, and the left eye is not necessarily supposed to be long-lasting, but I did specify it to be waterproof. So they're both staying put pretty much, but I think it's time to test it a little more than just wearing it around.
So this first test
is the nap test. So basically, I'm gonna take a little sleep right now. I'm gonna start on one side, and then after 10 minutes, Tyler will come in and force me to rotate to the other side.
It's gonna be like a pancake flip.
Exactly.
All right, it's time to roll over.
And basically, we're gonna see if any mascara rubs off on the pillow.
Oh, you're out of it, huh? I brought you crust to hang out
with. Oh, I'm gonna eat my mascara off.
But this is just an excuse for you to take a nap in the middle of filming.
I have engineered this perfectly. Anything on the pillow?
I don't think so.
I think it's staying on.
All right, 10 more minutes?
Yeah.
All right, soft and crusty. Any mean cat noises?
How'd I do?
Yeah, there's nothing on your pillow.
Wow. I felt like I was really hitting the pillow that time.
Oh, you wanna wake up?
No.
All right, so I actually think that this mascara survived the nap pretty well. I don't think any debris came off from either side, and I also don't see any sort of like smudges underneath my eyes. So I guess there's really only one more thing to do in the wear test, and that's a crying test. So I'm gonna go downstairs and cut some onions.
All right, so I'm here with an onion and a knife. Please, no comments on my cutting technique. Just like typing, I didn't learn the right way, but I now operate on my own scheme.
Feeling any tears there?
Not yet. Should I go closer?
Sure.
Oh yeah, that was good.
You feeling the tears now?
I gotta do this. Oh yeah, that stings. Oh!
Damn those ninjas cutting onions.
Is this a meme I don't know?
Isn't it a comment meme? You know what makes me sad?
What?
That little animated spider. He's so cute.
All right, now we got some tears. There we go.
I have a problem, Ty. I'm crying more out of my right eye than my left.
So we have an uneven crying distribution?
Yeah, I got my left eye going.
Did anything happen?
I think your mascara looks unscathed. Should we spray you in the eyes with like a super soaker?
You wanna just throw some water at my face?
How would that prove?
That'll be fun for you.
All right, let's try this.
No, I'm like a dog, no! I'll stop, I won't pee on the couch. No!
Okay, so I didn't bawl. I didn't get to like tears streaming down my face sobbing, but I definitely had some tears forming in my eyes, and then Tyler threw some water at my face. So I feel like we like reasonably tested this mascara within some watery situations. I think that the left eye looks really strong. That's the one that's supposed to be waterproof. And the right eye also looks pretty good. I don't know if it's like a shadow or what, but there does seem to be like the tiniest little bit of a smudge under here. But I think in general, both mascaras did pretty well. So after both of these mascaras have pretty much like proved their worth, I wanted to take a look at their ingredients and just see like how different they are. The actual ingredients, I feel like we shouldn't like go too far into because I am not a chemist and I don't know exactly what they do. But I'll say that like the first three or four ingredients are pretty similar. And then the rest of the ingredients seem to be similar but in different orders, which leads me to believe that the formulas are in fact at least somewhat different in their composition. Also what's interesting is that printed on the top of these paper slips are FO2 and FO6, which leads me to believe that Eyeko has like a set number of formulas, and based on how you answer their questions, they will like assign you a formula. So it's not exactly bespoke or one of a kind, but it is like a customized sale. Like it's like, well, you wanted this. So the formulas, although similar, are definitely different. But to me, like the true X factor of this customized mascara is the brush. So I went back to the Eyeko website to see if they sold these brushes with other mascaras that they already sell. And I found a few interesting things. So the ones that stick out to me as dupes for the SN mascara are the Lash Alert mascara and also the Black Magic mascara. I think the Black Magic mascara has my exact same brush, and it also has tubing technology and shea butter. The Lash Alert mascara seems to use like a slightly smaller brush, but it also has shea butter and tubing technology, and I feel like the vibe is the same. Like this was supposed to be like a quick fix, and this one is a wake up and go. So I feel like you might not be able to get like the exact combination of everything you want in the mascaras they already have, but you could probably get pretty close and pay like $10 to $14 less. But that's just my thought. So first and foremost, I think that both of these mascaras are very good mascaras. They both lasted all day, and they stood up very well to our official tests. And even though my SN mascara wasn't waterproof, it doesn't seem to be too smudgy. I think I was initially skeptical about the idea of customized mascara, because when I hear the words custom mascara, I think like How customized can you really make it? And I do think they ended up giving me a good formula that addressed a lot of my lash concerns, but some of the things that they say are like really impressive about your customized formula are things that a lot of their mascaras have, like tubing technology and shea butter, and even my favorite brush. I do think that their quiz could point you in the right direction of like the products you should be looking at, but I don't know that they should be charging you more for like a customized preset formula. I do not know about the personalized experience. I feel like maybe it's more fun to like go into the store and like test out the brushes, you know, maybe pop some bottles. But as far as the online experience goes, I would say maybe get a normal one and definitely don't get it monogrammed. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you liked that video, make sure to smash that like button. And if you want to see more videos like this, make sure to smash that subscribe button. A big shout out to Callum for watching. Thanks for watching, Callum, and I will see you guys next time.